Hi friends, welcome to the Python for Beginners course, and in this video we are going to talk of range function. So in the previous video we have done something like this. So we passed in two arguments to range instead of one, which we have learned it in the previous videos, that we pass in one argument to range and it returns a list of values ranging from 0 to the value which we have passed in. Now if you see range function, it's a function which can have multiple arguments separated by a comma. And range is not the only function. There are a lot of functions in Python which supports calling them by using multiple arguments, and range is just one of them. So range has three arguments. Out of these three, two are optionals. So we can call range in either of these three ways. So the first way is calling range with just one argument, and if we call in range with one argument, it will simply go and return a list ranging from 0 to the value n minus 1. So it will go and return a list from 0 to 4, and that's pretty simple, we already knew it. Next thing is calling range with two arguments. So these three arguments which we pass to the list are starting, stopping and stepping arguments. So the first argument is starting argument, and it is optional. We may define whether the range ranges from 0 or from this particular element. That means if we call range with 1 to 5, instead of starting with 0, the list which is returned by this function range will start with 1. So it will start with 1 and keep on going until 5 minus 1, that is 4. So now in this case it will return a list which is having the values 1 2 3 4, and it is not started with 0 because we have exclusively mentioned it. And if we do not pass this argument, the default is 0, that's why it starts with 0. Next is calling range with three arguments. So the first argument is starting. We define how, from where the list will start. Second argument is stopping. We define when to stop. And the third argument is stepping. That means how much we need to increment the value in successive iterations. That means if you look at this, in this particular case we start with 0 and go up to 4, and each value is incremented by 1, and that's because this is default. In this case we exclusively defined that we want to start with 1 and go to 5, so we get this list from 1 to 4. And in this particular example we defined that we need to start with 1, go to 5 minus 1, and in each iteration we want to increment the value by 2. That is, we do not want to increment it by 1, instead we want to increment it by 2. So the first value will be 1, then it will be incremented by 2, so that will become 3. So first is 1, then is 3, and it will store 3 here, and then this 3 will be incremented by 2, 5. And because it's not going up to 5, so we will only have a list having 1 or 3. So let's just see how it happened in this way, in this function. So we simply define the range that return a list which starts with 1 and ends at 4 minus 1, that is 3. So it returns a list 1, 2, 3, and for values 1, 2, 3, the square of 1 is printed, and that's how we get 1 square 1, 2 square 2, and 3 square as 9. So that's how we call range function. And if you have any doubt, you can comment in the comment section below, or you can also mail me to my mailing address admiralghost@gmail.com. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe to my channel Admiral Ghost, and see you in the next video.